So the garden was not a success this year. We didn't have a lot of time this spring to make the raised bed and collect the dirt. So we ended up with kind of poor quality dirt, very acidic, which means that things didn't grow up very well. The tomatoes kind of grew up half the size that they usually do. We also planted a lot more diversity of crops to harvest, but we have a rabbit around that kind of ate all of it. We're not mad, he's a cute little rabbit, so we're happy we could feed him. On top of that, we weren't here for pretty much a whole month of August, even some of September, so we weren't here to maintain it. Obviously, that shows, and the garden didn't do well. So we decided for next year, instead of clearing more trees around the cabin, that we would go down by the sugar shack and use the area that's already cleared up. There's some smaller trees, but they're easy to take off, so we'll just do that. We also just got a secondhand greenhouse that we're gonna install next to Sugar Shack, so hopefully that's gonna help us have a little bit more produce for next year. However, we decided to keep those raised beds anyways. They're already filled with dirt, so even though the soil is very acidic, there's some plants that do like that, so we're thinking maybe we're gonna plant some blueberries in them next year.
So we've had a spare solar panel sitting in our sugar shack here for quite a while now. We've been wanting to use it here at the sugar shack, but we just haven't had the time to set up the rest of the solar system. But thanks to Yoshino, today's sponsor, we finally have a complete and usable solar power system. We picked up the B2000 model, and we're very excited to show it to you. What makes the B2000 remarkable is its new solid-state battery technology. This technology allows the battery to weigh up to 50% less than traditional lithium-ion batteries, which is a huge deal for us because we plan on transporting it between our sugar shack and our greenhouse, which you'll be seeing us build pretty soon. The B2000 packs 1.3 kilowatt hours of power in less than 15 kilograms, which is unmatched by any competitors. Solid-state batteries are also much safer than liquid batteries in that they have no risk in combustion at high temperatures, which will make it safe for us to use in here in the sugar shack while we're boiling maple syrup. It also has a very long lifespan of 2,500 cycles, which is 2.5 times better than traditional lithium NCM batteries. The last major selling point of the B2000 for us is its performance in cold temperatures. Compared to traditional liquid batteries that can't perform well below freezing, the B2000 can still charge in as low as minus 10 Celsius, and is still usable down to minus 20 Celsius, which is perfect for us to use in the sugar shack and the greenhouse in March and April, when temperatures are typically still below freezing at night. In terms of the output of the B2000, there are 4 AC outlets, there's a wireless charging dock on top, there are 2 ports for 12-volt DC output, 2 USB-C ports, and 2 USB-A ports.
The B2000 can be recharged from 0 to 80% in less than an hour.
The B2000 also has 3 ways to be charged. There's using a solar panel like we've shown. There's also your standard 3-prong AC input. And lastly, a 12-volt DC car input. So thanks again to Yoshino for sponsoring this video. If you're interested in Yoshino products, be sure to click on the link in our description and use the code SST50 to get $50 off your purchase. So let's get back to the video.
On the topic of maple syrup, we're gonna go ahead and tag some maple trees before they lose their leaf, so we're gonna know which one we need to tap in spring.
can see where they tapped it in previous years.
Putting it under, over, but oh.
I think I have to go under. Here, yeah. I have this side set up. You want to go bolt it?
Yeah.
We'll do this side. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So our ladder that you saw us build last episode was feeling a little bit wobbly side to side, and that's because the one piece that we used to mark the notches of the rungs just so happened to be an eighth of an inch thicker than all of our rungs, so it was kind of unfortunate. So you can see there's a little bit of gap between each of the rungs. So we just added some little angle braces under each of them, and now it's a lot more sturdy.
Thanks. 26.58.
we were just cutting some trees and we started to hear a really loud buzzing noise. So that was our cue to run away as fast as possible. We came back a little bit later and sure enough, right around the ground, we saw a big wasp nest about this big. So it's a good thing we didn't take any steps further in that direction because I'm sure we would have been covered in stings. So we're gonna stay away from that area, but you can take a look at the wasp nest. We took some footage of it.
So after doing a little bit of research, they look to be bald-faced hornets. But if any of you are insect experts and want to correct us on that, please let us know in the comments.
Oh, doors to go on the other side. So yesterday we had a high of 28 Celsius. Today is a high of 27 Celsius. So for the first week of October, it is ridiculously hot. I don't think I've ever experienced this before. So needless to say, we are sweating today.